Pastor Robert Morris, the senior pastor of Gateway Church, one of the largest churches in America, has permanently resigned in shame and disgrace. This is after a lady he molested when she was just 12 years old for 4.5 years finally exposed him. When the lady, who is now 54 years old, did the interview with an online magazine exposing him, the elders of Gateway Church released a statement to their staff saying that Morris had a moral failure 35 years ago and was involved in an inappropriate sexual behavior with a young lady that involved kissing and petting and not intercourse. They insisted that he underwent a lengthy restoration process and has since walked in purity and therefore was not disqualified from ministry. Since then, more details have emerged that have proven Pastor Robert had been giving a false account of what had happened. Pastor Robert said that he resumed doing ministry with the blessing of the victim's father. According to Cindy, her father told Pastor Robert that, I quote, "I've turned you over to God. You're just lucky I didn't kill you." I think the pastor's resignation was a matter of when, not if, he would resign. In another interview, his victim had wondered how a person who claims went through restoration process would be lying to maintain his position in the church. The statement released by the Gateway Church Board of Elders to the media said that, and I quote, I believe this is a huge relief for Cindy, who wanted him to be held accountable for his actions and fired from his pastoral position. As you have noticed, he had even lied to the elders and didn't disclose everything about the moral failure. He lied that it happened with a young lady while she was a child of 12 years, and the molestation went on for an extended period. This shows he was more concerned about his reputation and protection of the church, neglecting the welfare of his victim. Cindy said that he had reached out to many pastors to help hold him to account, but none helped. She said, and I quote, "As I have End quote. This shows that the earlier statement by the Gateway's Board of Elders that they didn't have all the details was a lie. So, what do you think? Do you think the Gateway Church elders handled this issue well? Let me know at the comments section. Cindy believes there are more victims, and they should be bold like her to come out and share their story. She said, "This is just the beginning. I wholeheartedly and sadly believe I am not the only victim. I encourage anyone who has been sexually victimized by a leader at Gateway Church to take the bold step forward and say something. Now is the time. Please know that you will be supported and will not walk this journey alone. I hope and pray that the leadership at Gateway Church will echo this encouragement, knowing that this can be an opportunity to find the truth while providing help and restitution to victims." Fortunately for Pastor Robert, he was close to his retirement, and his son James Morris had already been appointed to succeed him in 2025. As he steps down, the Gateway Church should consider giving Cindy Clemishere and any other victim who may speak out a contrite apology. Financial remuneration from Robert for years of financial counseling, and praise from all quarters for her bravery so she can finally heal. Thank you for watching, and see you in my next video. I will leave you with the whole statement for your reading.